Hello friends, in this video I will explain what a plumbing trap actually does, what type of plumbing traps are available and in what situations people use it. So let's begin. Plumbing consists of pipes which bring water to the building and take the sewage away. The sewer pipe is the pipe which carries the sewage to the disposal system. Sewer gas is formed in the natural breakdown of solids in wastewater due to the activity of the bacteria. Sewer gas may not only have an offensive odor, it may include methane, which is potentially combustible. Common gases that are produced in a sewage system are methane, hydrogen sulfide, nitrogen, and carbon monoxide. To avoid the entry of these gases, insects, bacteria, cockroaches, mice inside the home or building, traps are constructed at the end of soil or waste pipes. A trap is a length of pipe with a curve that bottoms out with P or S shape. The curve holds a pool of water that seals out gases rising from the sewer side of the pipe. Nearly all sewer pipes and fixtures in a building will have a trap water seal. These seals are very important as they stop the gases which form in sewer pipes from coming into the building. Therefore, all plumbing fixtures such as sinks, wash basins, bathtubs, and toilets etc. are equipped with traps. Good traps should have following qualities. Trap should provide enough water seal around 50 mm under all conditions of flow. Interior surface of trap should be smooth so that flow is not obstructed, which enables self-cleansing. An access door should be provided for cleaning the trap. Trap should be made of non-absorbent material. Diameter of the trap shall in no case be smaller than the diameter of the outlet of the fixture to which it is connected. Trap seals break down due to the following reasons: trap siphonage, back pressure, wind effect, evaporation, and capillary action. These reasons we will discuss in some other video. Types of traps: floor trap or Nahani trap. Floor trap is located below the floor to collect wastewater from bathroom, wash area, wash basin, and kitchen sink, etc. These are available in cast iron or UPVC material and have removable grating on top of the trap. The minimum depth of water seal should be 50 mm. Gully trap. A gully trap is provided outside the building before connecting it to external sewage line. It collects wastewater from the kitchen sink, wash basins, baths, and wash area. It also prevents the entry of cockroaches and other insects from sewer line. P trap, Q trap, and S traps are classified according to their shapes. P-trap. If you look under any sink, you will see a curved pipe connected to the drain. In most cases, this pipe forms the shape of an inverted letter P with a horizontal section that runs into the wall where the drain is located. This trap is used with Indian water closet, Orissa pattern, kitchen, and bathroom. These kind of traps are made from PVC pipe or steel. S-trap. Like a P-trap, an S-trap has an inverted curve, but it lacks the horizontal arm. Instead, it curves down, then up, then down again, like the letter S, and connects to the drain pipe in the floor. This trap is used for fixing water closets in toilets. The only difference between P-trap and S-trap is that P-trap is used for outlet through the wall, whereas S-trap is used for outlet through the floor. Q-trap. This trap is used in toilet under water closet. It is almost similar to S-trap and is used in upper story other than ground floor. Intercepting trap. An interceptor manhole is provided at the intercept of building sewer and public sewer. This trap is provided at the last manhole of building sewerage to prevent the entry of foul gases from public sewers to building sewers. It has a deep water seal of 100 mm. Bottle trap. This trap is used below wash basin and sinks to prevent entry of foul gases. Normally, the bottom unscrews to allow the clearing of blockages, etc. They can be deeper than the P-trap and S-traps. Grease trap. Common wastewater contains small amounts of oils, which enter into septic tanks and treatment facilities to form a floating scum layer. The septic tank contains microorganisms. This scum layer is very slowly digested and broken down by microorganisms in the anaerobic digestion process. In case of restaurants, large amounts of oils from food preparation can overwhelm a septic tank, causing release of untreated sewage into the environment. Restaurant and food service kitchens produce much waste grease, which is present in the drain lines from various sinks, dishwashers, and cooking equipment. If it is not removed, the grease can clump and cause blockage in the sewer. To avoid this, grease trap is installed in the waste pipe for the purpose of separating grease from liquid and retaining the grease. Grease and hair are generally the causes of drain clogs. That's why traps often have clean-out plugs that give you easier access to remove or break up any blockage. Grease traps can be made up of concrete, fiberglass, or steel. When the outflow from the kitchen sink enters the grease trap, the solid food particles sink to the bottom, while lighter grease and oil floats to the top. The relatively grease-free water is then fed into the normal septic system. The solid food particles, floating oil, and grease must be periodically removed in a manner similar to septic tank pumping. If a floor drain doesn't have water flowing to it on a regular basis, the water in the trap will dry out. If a drain, sink, or toilet is not used for a long time, or if there is a leak in the P-trap, it may go dry and allow sewer gas to rise into a home. To refill a P-trap, flush the toilet, pour water in the floor drain, or run water down the sink. Then check to make sure the sewer gas has stopped coming into the building. If sewer gas continues, a repair or other maintenance may be needed. Whenever you encounter a strange odor in any room where there is a drain, always make sure that the trap is not dry. This is usually a quick fix that can be remedied by running water down the drain and filling the trap back up with water. Wherever the surrounding temperature goes below 0 degrees Celsius, RV antifreeze can be used into the drain. RV antifreeze is cheap, sold everywhere, safe for the environment, and it won't evaporate or freeze. Another option is to periodically pour some water down the drain. You will obviously need to do this regularly, but it is free and easy to do. Toilets have their own built-in traps, and so do floor drains. So friends, I hope I have covered enough information about plumbing traps in this video. Like this video if you learned something, and be sure to share it with someone who might benefit from it. If you have any suggestions, you can mention it in the comment section. Subscribe to Engineering Motive for more such videos and ring that notification bell so that you won't miss the new video. Finally, thanks for watching.